Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
You live one life, think thrice.
And yes, people, take it in. It's a Wednesday. If you have someone you wanted to crush on and she's female, today's the day. But if you ask me honestly, I like to crush on females on a daily, not in that kind of light. My name is Tina Fierce One, and welcome to Scoop and Scoop. Oh, well, I honestly thought that after they had enrolled Fresh Kid into school and the buzz on him had kind of like died down, we're going to not do stories about him and just wait for him to keep making, I don't know what, news or whatever it is. But it seems this boy, like he is part of my job now. Every time something happens to this boy, they finna call me. Now, I'm tired of making these calls, but it's my job. So, without further ado, let me give you the deets on Fresh Kid. So, I am chilling, I get a story from a random, because that happens to me a lot. And they tell me, well, check this out. According to Mbu Ntino, Fresh Kid's manager was saying that Omana ina accounts, na etala banga konga bamutera ko sente, tamanyo wa sente zebu akola azifuna. I'm like, wait, what? I thought it's in the manager's interest to actually think of his artist. Then I'm like, you know what, before I can even delve into this story, before I can actually delve into it, let's listen to what the manager had to say, because this was a hearsay rumor that I actually had to first confirm. So we gave him a phone call. We wanted to hear what he had to say. And this is what he told us.
Mbu, mbu, okusinzira kubwe, bayogezeza gweno, mbu gwogamba, buchanga Fresh Kid atandika kukola, Toteikanga ko sente kwa account ya Fresh Kid zonozi watatawe. Chitufu?
Okuteka sente kusi?
Kwa account ya Fresh Kid inga iye. Mbuzo na zigenderi.
Chuu, mbwene nozi teka ko. Bia diwe ya nozi teka. Tarazi mbwene bia diwe ya na teka ko. Chuu,
mbwene. Si ya gwe. Anti ngeri jeba, boba looze, ngeri joli manager ye. Baba ira, gogo basasula, gwenozi sayo.
Eke tolo chikola
Nga
dadi abatali woba manga shaba nze dadi aneka echo kiraba bulabi nawe nga manga wane dadi lwaki mbate balina kibonga bo balina okuhandolinga ekintu ekyo bulungi nze gundi yange lolo yange makinga sure bazifunye
gwe kati oliwo ku makinga sure bakoze ne bazifuna kati mukulaba okuko bali oloza bazikozesa bulungi oba omwana ye afunye ko nga ye oba zonna zigenda eri bo be baziyiza
kyolina okukola kyemitaano kina kiyinza kugambako ekyo wabula ze naba wagundi ekira kyokugira kyokugenda okugirambula kulambula kankuba zina babiri waliwo iye olina okubeera kozesa obusente bwakozesa neri 60 obusente buyinza omuyambako in case of waliwo kibadde obutegerawo ebitebe neri 60 for 10 years so nabasuubiza okubanga time genabo ebadde genatukawo natuuka njagenda genda.
If you ask me, this manager has learned his art. He has learned PR. He knows what he's supposed to say, when he's supposed to say it. But though, in the streets, on the streets of gossip, it's a different story. He tells different people different things. But I always love to call him because when I call him, he gives me somewhat clarity. Now, my question is, remember when I asked you guys, how long do you see this boy living on this how long do you see him having a career in this here industry? And everybody was like, nah, Tina, like he can do school and then he can do music. Well, it's different when both your parents are broke and looking at you for the next paycheck. Now, this is what is going to break this boy. And I was right to tell you, in 3 years to come, this boy is going to be nowhere. This boy is going to go back to poverty. He's going to go back to living on former glory reason. His parents, now, of course, someone is going to tell you like, yo, Tina, you don't even know how they're using it. If your father stands up and you're what? How old is this guy boy? 2. He is 6 and your father stands up and says, as his father, this is a guy who dumped him with his mom, wasn't doing anything. He's like, as his father, I need a house, I need a car. Do you honestly think that boy is going to be getting money? Do you for a minute believe that that fixed account that he's talking about is actually going to be getting any money? Now, according to the manager, he says they opened up a fixed account that has a time span of when they can get that money, and that money should be Fresh Kids savings. Now, he has two accounts. One account, the parents officially run. Then I asked about the joint fixed account that is his, because he cannot have an account, he's mine. And he goes like, still, it's the parents that are running that money. Now, this is coming from a mother who came out on national television and she was crying for her child. And she's like, what did you call him manager? Kuba mwana wabera ni manager, ziba zijawani. Uwe, tata na ena abinge mnagamba, mwana wange, na ena mstula na mtuwala. So this boy's downfall is actually not going to be him because he's a child. It's his parents. And then I ask you, same people who are out here giving him all this hope, this glory, this love. I'm like, yeah, he can do it, he can do it. Have you noticed that this boy cannot go any further with his career if his parents are going to be a part of this life he's living? And to just think about it. Now, I still felt like that wasn't enough because it wasn't clarification enough for me. I'm like, so wait, that fixed account, Sente Bazijayonga ine miyake mekanga, inamwezi gumu miyake etano miyaka mkaga. He goes like, well, we set out a debt. I call a banking friend of mine. And he goes like, yeah, you can open up a fixed account for a minor and then have a particular debt. According to the manager, yabagamba, yobu se, echiseda banka che yamugamba, wachina atuka, agenda genda yuna haba za debe, batunula baba labonga jizigenda, na yabu wa ombu zanzi. Oyo mwana taina yuna chikumi. Taina yuna chikumi. Because his parents are looking at him as a next paycheck. Do you know what it means for your parents to stop looking at you as a child, but a paycheck? And I know most people are going to be like, Tina, who are you to judge? I have so many reasons to judge. I do. But apparently he's doing good. I've seen photos of him on social media. The school is making so much good buzz with him. I mean, they let camera people come into the classroom, take photos of him. I don't know how the kids around him are feeling, like, who is this guy? Okay, we know that guy, but man, this is what happens when you reap talent when it's way too young to make its own decisions. I kept telling people this. A minor is a minor. Their thoughts are their thoughts if they have any at all. Now, if you're lucky and you have people who want the best for you, you can make this paper. But if you're unlucky and you have parents like Fresh Kids parents, it's a trip, it's a joke. Sigena na chidako, but according to him, the woman says the money keeps going to the father. The father says the woman, he has an upcoming concert in Dubai. Yeah, this boy is moving paces and bases. Katulinde binave Yerusalem na enza nabagambe miyake eju. Eju. Tetugenda kuluwa wawo. Tuchireke. Anywho, moving on to other things. Now, Diamond Platnumz and his bae, Tinashe Dona, they give me life on Instagram. Like, they're all about them, you know? They just like to do things that are them. They're goofy, they're funny. So they posted a video a couple of days back. I didn't want to pay any attention until I saw the buzz coming from it and the commentary. And everybody's like, wait, Tinashe, you pregnant? I'm like, wait, what? Because they were wearing funny packs, right? I don't know if you guys understand funny packs, but they were wearing funny packs and it looked like she had a big stomach. It doesn't look like a stomach that should be seated on a very skinny girl like her. But then again, she's Tinashe. Her boobs look weird, her stomach look weird, her feet look weird. I mean, is she pregnant? Who knows? Is it true? Do we care? I mean, if Diamond has decided to go ahead and have kids in the entire, this entire Africa, it's all right. But I have a couple of words for Tinashe. I'm just saying, nobody's a bad person. I'm just asking. After seeing all the baby father drama that this guy has, what makes the women that come into this man's life believe that they are the one? What? What does this boy have? I know it's the money, but what? Why would you go ahead? That would be a hasty move. If she actually was pregnant, I would say wrong move, child. Wrong move. It's just off. It's wrong. Why? Why would you have another child for a man who has two baby mothers that is always bickering and saying, we don't have child support, you ain't a good daddy, to a man who actually jumped to say, daddy, nkusonyi. Why? But then again, people, love is blind. When it hits, I guess it hits. So if she's pregnant, let us not do much, but let's wish her luck. I think she needs all the luck she can get. I can't deal with this. I can't. Oh, Lord, I want to understand. understand what is in Chibu Dangote's trousers that makes all these here girls get cray cray. I want to understand it. But I guess I'll never understand it. I don't want to understand it in that light. Anyway, wabali rubuto, chibasanyulanga bo, baba tedulimu, girl, hit the gym, eat a salad or something. For a skinny girl, it looks bad for you to have a fupa that big. Has you ever had kids? Those boob looks like she has had kids before. Anyway, who am I to judge? Does it matter? Moving on to other interesting things. Now, y'all remember Aisha Nabukeera, Frank Gashumba yaimirira wo, namwe yaimirira, actually he raised her. Now, I saw the post on Facebook with actually Frank Gashumba was the one talking about it, and he's like, you go, girl, I'm so proud of you, blah, blah, blah. She's going to do something with the Bill Gates and Melinda Gates Foundation. I'm like, yes, to win it. I mean, she's going to be telling her story, like she survived. She did. She was a banned victim out of hate crime and from a stepmom that was sad. She has the scars to tell the story for. I'm like, that's you winning. Nayaba na Uganda temuko watemweba katemus musula bubi. People had the audacity to jump on Frank Gashumba's page while he's trying to gloat for a minute and go like, aw. So sad that the one who actually dropped out is somewhere, living her life with a sugar daddy. And the one that was picked up as a stray is out here moving paces. Now, if you ask me, I think this is what Frank Gashumba actually meant. This is what he meant when he was like, we are grooming Sheila to be a world leader. We are grooming her to be all of these things. Mm-mm. He was talking these things. I'm like, proud of her. You know, it's a good thing. It's a good situation. I hope her sister can, you know, borrow a leaf from this. But what for? Apparently, they're all living their best lives. Apparently. Sheila is out there throwing birthday parties with her God's plan. Indeed, it was a God's plan for these people. Because when you try to get into the intricate details of things I cannot say on TV, it's a nasty situation. Too nasty for me. But we shall still take a minute and applaud this young woman who has faced almost every adversity. And she's still standing from a tender age. We all saw her story. It was heartbreaking. And we all know that Frank Gashumba put the money elsewhere. But hey, we are not going to talk about that. We're going to say kudos for the one that failed to turn out right. You did right by this one. It's a good situation. This is me honestly telling Frank Gashumba as a fellow parent, you did good. You did right. For a minute. But David, I'm going to be there, but someone has told me, remember when I told you guys that Kent and Flosso had been fired by their management? They all went back to their respective sleepovers, their respective baby mamas, their respective ubiyako zebiti akati. His baby mama. She was ranting on social, people. She was ranting. Now, I want to run this story in its entirety tomorrow because I want to get all the sides of the juice. I do. I want to understand why these two dimwits can be that, they can have that much bad luck. Is it bad luck? Is it laziness? What is it? Which one slept with Zara Toto in a tent at Nyege Nyege? I keep telling people success and failure is sexually transmitted too. Mind the people that you sleep with. I'm just going to put it like that. But that's not in my place to say. I'll run the whole story another time. But for now, let's take a short break. Don't forget that Scoop and Scoop is proudly sponsored by Lucky 3 Bet Chisoboka. Let's go back. Take a break, and we'll be back with Yap Trending.
Scoop and Scoop is sponsored by
Kind of like a three. Chisoboka. Kufuka bus, no jog. Chisoboka. You live one life, think thrice. Chisoboka.